Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're diving into a few of the updates that Trello have hinted at in one of their latest blog posts. Now on October the 26th, a week ago now, they hinted a little bit more about some of the viewing options for Trello. And in today's video, we're going to overview what that means and also take a look at how their team view or team table view is progressing. Okay, so for those who are new, please do make sure you are subscribed to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It'd be fantastic to have you. So as many know, Trello has been a remote company. Well, what they're calling remote hybrid company for about 10 years now, with some of their employees working from home and obviously a lot of them working in the office. However, they've sort of got that blend between both working in the office and at home. So Michael Pryor, the CEO of Trello, posted a blog post about how they're looking to move forward and expand on the different ways that teams can interact with information. Now, this is a really popular topic at the moment with applications like ClickUp, Monday, and Notion, as well as Airtable, adding plenty of new views for teams. Teams are looking to take advantage of information as they express it in different ways. Trello talks about this a lot in the blog post, talking about cross-functional teams using this in different aspects and being able to view the data in different manners. So obviously Trello hinted a few months ago, I think it was a month and a half ago, at the table view, and this is now in beta. We'll show you this near the end, but it was the first hint of a different view, and they also mentioned more views coming. So by the look of the blog post, they're also working on a timeline view for teams, and they're looking specifically at adding this to the business class plan of Trello, which has all of the features like Butler and more. So this timeline view would allow you to see projects as cards that expand over a set time period, much like a Gantt chart. And also, much like the applications like ClickUp and Monday, you'll be able to view it in this more linear view, allowing you to see, for example, a task or a card with the tags and the people assigned to it. So those two views are very popular inside of existing applications. And there is a third view they're hinting at as well, which is more of a dashboard view, allowing you to see graphs and charts of specific pieces of data. And I can see this working a lot with the Butler application, as it works with other applications to bring in useful data. So they also announced that the business class and enterprise users can now try the table view as beta, and they can also try some of the beta dashboard and timeline views, Trello views, in the coming week. So I just wanted to show you, if you're a business class customer, how you can do this. Now, I found this quite easy to do, but all you have to do is open the board you're accessing and go over to the top left-hand side, and you'll be able to see this new option called Open Team Table. Once you click this, it will go into a separate view, which is pretty much your profile view. And as you can see here, you can bring in certain boards. So let's demonstrate how this works. So as you can see here, I've brought in the CRM pipeline, but you can add more boards. And this is so that you can conglomerate bits of information together and pick out what is relevant. Basically, advanced sorting and filtering across multiple boards. So if I brought in another CRM, a CRM and sales pipeline, maybe I wanted to see all of the different leads that I have at the moment. And in this case, maybe I want to narrow it down based on the labels that they have. So as you can see here, you can narrow it down by selecting some of the different lists they're a part of. For example, I selected the new leads and leads from both lists, and you'll be able to see, for example, an outline of which ones are currently leads across both boards. So this might be useful if you're working in teams and you want to see, for example, you could see a certain list or progress. You could even see the prioritization of a task. Like, for example, if you've all assigned something to be high priority, what's high priority over three or four boards that you're working on at the moment? This could be useful for managers and folk that are looking to sort of get a holistic overview without necessarily having to micromanage each board. And you could even select a specific due date, whether they're overdue or due in the next couple of days, to see what your team are working on or what your priorities are as an employee. So you'll be able to view this through the table, team table. I can see this being actually embedded in a view inside of this view here, which I'm sure will be much more suitable when people get started. So all in all, this is quite exciting news for Trello, mainly because Trello has been very fixed in its ways for quite a while now, only sort of keeping that board view, maybe the calendar view, but they've definitely been investing a lot in the butler automations. They've been looking at more views, which is really good, in an effort to keep up with the competitive players like ClickUp, Monday, Airtable, and many more that are rising in the market right now. So it will be exciting to see how this rolls out. You can check this out on Business Class Plan. Obviously, it's not fully integrated, still early days development, but very much an interesting update to Trello, and good to hear that things are coming and progressing in the future, especially because a lot of people, maybe this time 2 years ago, were worried that the acquisition by Atlassian was too much and that obviously that could have led to their demise. But it's definitely looking like they're investing much more inside the Trello experience. So folks, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do check out the podcast. We've got Keep Productive News podcast, which is great. If you want to keep updated with the latest news, we'll make sure to include this one. And also, if you're new here to the channel, please do make sure to subscribe. Anyway, folks, a huge thank you, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.